Hello everybody, and welcome to episode 3 of Project Infinity. Like always, I got myself a lot of cool stuff planned, and we did a lot of cool work between the episodes, so let's get started. So first of all, I will quickly mention what I did between the episode, or what we did, I should say, and then I can get going on the actual, you know, creating of cool stuff this episode. So, as you can see, we currently have doubled the power generation due to windmills, or water wheels, because we were kind of short on power, and we do have kind of a cool idea for a new way of power generation soon, which will also involve water wheels, but on a way bigger scale. But that does require a little bit more time and a lot of people to actually get going on that project. So that will be for a little bit later probably. Then what I did is I marked off the entire area with fences and I made it look just a little bit nice right here with some of these oak slabs and some gates and all. Just because we were having some trouble with random creepers just falling out of the sky for some reason. So decided to make it a little bit safer for that because it's not that much fun when half of your base gets blown up every time a surprise creeper pops up. Yes, I'm talking to you. And even though I am the Creeper King slash Agent Boom. Yeah, that's Agent Boom. Yes, I know. I like this cool outfit thingy that I'm wearing. I am not a fan of creepers, personally. Then on the inside, as you can see, we did a lot of work too. Because mainly we want to make this look a lot better than what it used to look like. So we moved a lot of stuff into the bigger area, made it just look a lot nicer down here with some of these stone bricks and oak wood planks from Chisel, this thingy right here. It's pretty cool. Due to that, we also have this new power line set up, which looks a lot cleaner in my opinion. Two MFEs as a pretty much like a buffer for all the power that's going in. And two breaker switches, so we can turn off either all of these machines right here. And I also added another one for the thermionic fabricator, because this thingy keeps using power when it's, even when it's not running. So, yeah, that's why. And another one right here that's going through the floor, again to the crushers and such downstairs. Pretty awesome. Down here, not too much has changed. I haven't gotten around to making this look all that fancy yet, but don't worry about that, because I most likely will. Pretty awesome. Then there's one more cool thing that I would like to show you, which I did not do much of, but I believe a Enterprise and Swans built, which is on the farming area of Project Infinity, right over here. Yeah, this is our new farming area. I think it looks absolutely awesome, though I'm not sure what's up with this stuff. Like, is that like just a glitch, graphical glitch or something? Let's see. What button is it to see the chunk borders? No, it's not the chunk borders that's making this thing look dark. That's weird. But pretty much, we got ourselves one of these robots right here that's picking up all of these crops and also replanting them. So we are getting ourselves a lot of industrial hemp fiber and wheat, and also a bit of ender pearls because of these ender lilies, but for some reason it doesn't like replanting that, so need to keep that in mind. So that's also something that I want to make today, which is a backpack. Backpacks are at least the ones that I want to make from Project Red, which pretty much allow you to store items. But they require a lot of string, so that's where we got the industrial hemp farm, because I should be able to turn this into string. Yeah, awesome. Also something that I got is this new bubble, the Ring of Magnetization from Batania, which is just a magnetization lens, which is this recipe, and a mana lens, which is made like so, and a quartz lens, or quartz sphere, which requires some quartz, because we do now have a portal to the nether, so that's pretty awesome. So we're able to get the basic nether materials and such going. Awesome. And then right here, we just got a little animal pen set up. What on earth happened right here? Something exploded, and I don't know what. And I don't have stuff on me, so this will do for now. Someone really has to pay attention to what they're doing in this base, because it's not the first time that all these animals are escaping for some reason. Yeah, that's not so fun. So let's see, like I said, what I want to do today first off is make the bag, or two maybe, because they are always useful to store your stuff on you and not having to run around back to your base every time you need to have some space. So yeah, let's do that. Let's run back here, over there, right here, eat some food, just cool. So let's see, for a bag I need 8 woven cloths, which require 8 string. Okay, so that's just a stack of these industrial hemp fibers each. And I could also make tough fabric. Can that be used for some sort of bag? No, only for the improved windmill, I see. And hempcrete? What on earth is that? I assume a variety of concrete. No idea. So let's see, Minecraft blocks, have some wood in here, let's turn that into that stuff. So I need this bag, 8, 16 sticks, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, there we go, then turn these into string. Go. Oh. Like that. And then I need 2 dice because I would like to make them look a little bit different. So do we have what do we have actually? Can I use Botania dice maybe? Red die, Gendustry, Project Red, Extra Bees, Gendustry. It doesn't show up. Perhaps I'll give it a try. So for that I need a flower, of course, and a mortar. I don't believe I actually have one of those, so let's see. Or do I? Nope, I don't. So let's see, in not enough items, it should be around here somewhere if I can find it. Okay, I'm being blind. One sec. Alright, there we go. 1 pestle and mortar. Then I should be able to do this and get the floral powder. So let's see. Can I actually do this? Aw, it really is just not compatible. That's too bad, because I really would like to have that color. At least I can make like one of these just yellow and perhaps able to get some red flowers somewhere. I mean, I would honestly be surprised if there are no red flowers to be found around here, like vanilla red flowers. So yeah, also, did I show you this thing? I made myself a nano saber, which is pretty much just a very powerful sword that runs on electricity if I turn it on with a simple right click. So that's pretty awesome. Really? No red flowers in the area? Alright, this is not going too well. Then I guess what I'll just... Oh wow, what's going on there? Oh wow, that I believe that's just a oil rig thingy that doesn't look too good. So yeah, then I guess I will just make one without a dye and one that's yellow. So I guess that should suffice, as I don't believe I have flowers anywhere. Like, I don't have it right here or something. Missed chest. Because that's something I totally do sometimes. Put stuff in the wrong chest. Just because I, you know, on accident. So one dye. One yellow one. And one white one. Awesome. And each one of these have pretty much a normal chest's worth of inventory. So that's awesome, and I'm not able to actually put the bag in here. Too bad. I'm not able to actually interact with these bags at all. Huh. Or... oh wait, I can. Never mind. Cool. So yeah, let's see what else I want to do. Okay, so what I think I would like to do is explore the Nether just a little bit more. See if there's anything cool just near the surroundings of our portal, and maybe get some other cool stuff. So I quickly put all my other important stuff that I don't need to carry on me in this white bag, which I put in this chest right here, just so I don't lose it when I die. So let's see, the Nether portal should be right here. What's in here? No idea. So let's see. Hopefully I don't get surprised, attacked by whatever I don't want to be attacked by. Which is actually a lot of stuff normally. So I do know that right here we spawn right next to a nether fortress. So that is pretty awesome, actually. Because I think I might want to get myself a couple of blaze rods. So what's this? Cobalt. Can I mine this? Effective level, pickaxe. Harvest level, cobalt. Darn, I'm not able to get cobalt. Does that mean I need to get myself an alumite pickaxe? I believe that's the case. I'll do that in a... Probably just a bit later. But for now, let's see what I can find in this place right here. So, where is the entrance? Or at least something that looks like one. Fair enough, I guess. So, nothing to be seen right here. Nothing there. No mobs at all. Ah! Okay, I definitely hate those things. Let's see. I'll probably go left first, see if there's something here. Okay, no, apparently it is not. Is it just really dark in here, or is it just me? Because it might just be me, though. But it looks pretty awesome right here. What's down here? Maybe some chests, something. Oh, hey, a chest. Let's see. Is there something in here? Settle. Golden chest plate, golden horse armor. I believe, yeah, I can resmelt this stuff to get some gold out of it, so that's pretty sweet. And I see on my tooltip there should be a blaze around here somewhere, so I'm not sure if that indicates to a blaze spawner or just a, you know, random blaze. I hope a blaze spawner, because that would be awesome. Nothing here. I really thought there would be more to this nether fortress. I mean, FTB Infinity experts, like hard mode stuff perhaps. But doesn't appear to be that the nether is a lot harder than what it used to be, apparently. Oh well. At least I can now harvest myself a bit of glowstone. And... ooh, a blaze spawner. Awesome. So, let's hopefully not die. And I hear a ghast somewhere, which I also don't want to be attacked by. What's this? A gluttony shard. Cool stuff. Any more? No? Well, at least I now know there is one right here. I see a couple more over there. Let's see what there is to do over here. Stupid ghasts. Ah, don't die, don't die, don't die. Okay, I'm running. Ah. I got two blaze rods and a uncommon treasure, which holds some gold. Eh, not really useful. But I do at least have some blaze rods. So let's see if I can do something with that soon. Alright, so I got a cool idea of something that I want to make that will most likely help me just to survive a little bit longer in the difficult situations. Which is a crossbow. The material that I most likely want to go for when making is Signalum. Signalum offers, from experience, a very fast draw speed on a crossbow. And, well, pretty much that is definitely what you want to have. So, this thing requires 10... redstone, which is molten redstone, actually, or a destabilized. So, luckily we got ourselves a magma crucible for that, so that's doable. 3 parts copper, 1 part silver. And this will give you 576, which should give me 4 ingots of signalum. Okay, so let's see. So, each copper and silver piece is 1 signalum. So I think that's actually quite doable. Because do we have any right now? Signalum? We have some, but I don't think that will be enough. So let's just make like a bunch more. So 16 copper. No, it was 3 parts, right? Yeah, so then let's do 15. 5 of those. And then I need 10, so 50 redstone. So that's that and 5 more. Okay. Let's magma crucible this up. Luckily, we are generating enough power for now, I think, so that shouldn't be too much of an issue. Molten cobalt in here. I'll live for that, actually. So, not too worried. So, let's see. Doable. How will I be able to actually get the redstone in that furnace, though? That's another question. I'll have to think of a way. In the meantime, let me quickly get my back. And got myself a bucket or two in here. So, 1, 2. I don't suppose I can just, like, right-click it or something somewhere. How did I go about doing this before? This is a very good question, because I have absolutely no idea anymore. How would I do this? Because I don't think there's any other easy way to get it in there. No. I should be able to pump it in, I think. But how would I do that? How would I, like, actually find something to pump it in? Let me do some thinking and I'll be right back. Okay, I think I have an idea. If this works, I have no idea, but, well, we'll see. So, I got myself a wooden pipe and some cactus green, which I can turn into pipe sealant to make wooden fluid pipes. Which should be able to transfer liquids. So, that is step one. Then what I probably will do is break one of these faucets. And, oh, don't do that. I might want to disable this for now, then. And break this, because otherwise to try to put the liquids in there, and that's definitely not something I want. Then I can put that right there. Then all I need is, I believe, another tank. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 glass. Should be one buildcraft tank. Put this on here. And I'm fairly certain this thing won't auto-extract in any way. It does not, so then I need a redstone... Wait, how does it work here? Apparently I have no idea how this works. Oh, this thing automatically outputs. I don't think I can use a portable tank to automatically output liquids. Can I? Let's try this. What's still in here? Less than a bucket. Let's try this out. Alright, let's try this again. This time with the portable tank set to output to the bottom. Awesome, it works. So, does the fluid go in here? Destabilize redstone, molten copper and silver. Yes, awesome. It's creating molten signalum. Exactly what I wanted to see happen. Woohoo. So, let's see. How much more do I have? 2 more or 3 more buckets. 1 more. There we go. Put this in. So now we should be getting ourselves a bunch of this molten signalum. So let's see. For a crossbow, I need a crossbow limb, tool rod cast, and a crossbow bolt. Someone beat me to it, apparently. Because these are exactly the components you need for a... Yeah, for a thingy. Let's see. I need one. Yes, that. This one. I don't need a tool rod, but I do need a binding. So, do I have one of those? Let's see. What did I need again? A piece of that stuff and a binding. Okay. Fiery bowstring, sure. Because apparently, like I said, someone beat me to it. And normal binding or tough binding? It doesn't show, but this looks like tough binding, so I will go with that probably. We'll need this one, I guess. So let's see if this works. Break this casting table, because I don't want blood in this thing for now. Where did it go? Did it? Oh, there. No, wait, that's a gossiping basin. Where is that thing? Oh, there we go. Just took a moment. I can break this for now. But this on here, it shouldn't do anything. Awesome. Let me quickly break this, otherwise my entire thing will go wrong. So one crossbow limb. Pouring it in. Awesome. One of whatever I just put right there. Can't recall the name. And then I need one more tough binding. There we go. And I still have 8 left. Oh, that's not too bad, actually. So let's see. This should be all the components that I need. 1, 2, and then again, one more in a second. There we go. And then go to this thingy. Right there. So let's see. Binding. A crossbow limb. A crossbow body. And some string. Create you a crossbow. Awesome. Let's name this the... how should I call it? Last time I called it the Foe Reaper. And I kind of liked that name. So let's just keep calling it like that. So, repair material Signalum, 800 durability, effective durability 888, because it has reinforced 1, draw speed 1/4 of a second, which is incredibly fast, and just the other stats are pretty sweet. So, of course, now I have myself the crossbow, but what can you do with a crossbow on its own? Absolutely nothing, because, of course, it requires some bolts. So let's make some bolts. For that, now I just remembered you need yourself a 2 cost, which suddenly makes a lot more sense. I think I can just make them out of molten signalum too. I don't think that's a bad material to use at all. So, why not? So what you do is you get yourself a normal 2 rod of any material. Then you get yourself, well, like I said, a 2 rod, if this hurries up. There you go. And you pour another material on top of it. And yes, it doesn't look like this will work, but hold on just a second. Takes a moment. There we go. And you get yourself a rod that looks slightly different. Why, you might ask? Because it is slightly different. Yes, shocker. There we go. Then you got yourself a signalum bolt. And you combine this with some fletching, I believe. Bolt. And fletching, yes. So, there are, let's see, I believe 3 kinds of fletching. Oh no, a bit more actually. Feather fletching, leaf fletching, slime fletching, and slime leaf fletching. But I think I might as well just use normal leaves, as I believe that's the only type that we actually have. Yeah, we have loads of leaves, so that's not something to be afraid of. Fletching pattern. There we go. Thank you to whoever actually put all this stuff already in here on the server. If you're watching, thank you very much. So then you put the bolt and the fletching. And you get yourself the, in this case, signalum bolt. Let's call this the... poison darts. Looks cool, right? So what you do is you right-click on your crossbow with this thing. And you see it will load it up. And then it should be able to show you the damage. As you can see, this thing will do 66.5 hearts of damage. Yes, you read that correctly. 66.5 hearts of damage. That's insane. Just... And it shoots fast. Like... That fast. And I should be able to just pick these up again. Just as easy as that. Oh, that is absolutely why I love crossbows. They are wonderful. So let's try this out on a couple of enemies if we can find some. Should be, you know, not too difficult to find, I guess. As it's nighttime, so. There we go. A zombie somewhere. Did I see a zombie? I did. Let's try this out. Boom. One-shot kill. There are very few things you can't insta-kill with this thing. I believe only things like bosses, like the Gaia Spirit or the Wither. But most other stuff will just be instantly dead with this crossbow. How awesome. Ooh, a leprechaun net. That's tree head leprechaun.
Oh, that looks so cool.
Yeah, awesomeness.
Don't you guys think?
I love it. So, yeah, I'll be right back. Oh, wow, we really went through this episode fast. I already checked and we're already at the end of the episode. Sorry, folks. So, I definitely hope you guys enjoyed, like always. If you have any suggestions, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below, as I will try to do as many of them as possible. So, if you have any builds, suggestions, maybe cool ideas of, I don't know, maybe specific mods you would like me to see do, just an idea. Let me know in the comment section below, and I will see what I will be able to do with them. Like always, be sure to check out my website in the description below for all my details about my website, or, yeah, about my blog, other website stuff, galleries, all that kind of cool information you might want to see. Thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.